here in this great city of this Hyderabad. And on behalf of Government of Nepal, Embassy of Nepal, and myself, I would like to extend my warm welcome to all of you for being part of this great seminar, where we will have lots of opportunity to discuss about Nepal-India relations, investment opportunities, and many more things that we have decided to discuss and move forward, that how we can promote our relationship, not only in terms of social culture, but also in terms of business, economic, trade, and other affairs. So let me welcome you. And I hope all of you have some types of commitment, all of you have some types of motivation to move forward or lead the discussion that you really wanted to have in Nepal and move forward in kind of special bindings with Nepal. As all of you know that Nepal and India has been enjoying very unique types of, exceptional types of relationship that is probably with only in between Nepal and India, none of any other country in the world. So today, I'm going to give a small glimpse that what types of opportunities these days Nepal government is offering to the Indian industrialist investors or business people who really want to get engaged in terms of their economic investment, or trade affairs, and other sort of relationship with Nepal. So allow me to give a very brief presentation that will help you to have a small guidance or glimpse or a kind of scenario that Nepal is offering. It's all about investment opportunities in Nepal. And today we will talk about trade, transit, tourism, cultural promotion, business activities, and many more. And we will also try to cover some investment-friendly instruments that we have adopted and introduced recently. And then we will also highlight some of the project banks that we have, ready-made projects where you can get engaged. And of course, comparative and competitive advantages and how diplomatic mission or our mission in Delhi could help you to coordinate you, to facilitate your business and investment with Nepal. And in conclusion, we will have some kind of discussion. So today, Nepal really want to invite all of you to come in Nepal and enjoy some of the special privilege that Indian investors have. And if you have any plan, whether it's multi-millionaire project or if thousands of rupees of project or whatever the size, regardless of the size, if you want to engage with Nepal, just discuss, move forward with your choices. And then we will work on it, we can design on it, we can coordinate, and we can link you up in Nepal, and then you will see how it's moving forward. And let me highlight some of the government. After a long time, recently we had various types of election, three layers of election, federal election, state level of election, and local level of election. So we got a big, or I would say strong type of stability. So all of our governance system has been now changed, and it's totally, absolutely investment friendly environment that we have in Nepal. Macroeconomic conditions, you see our GDP rate is growing and growing. This year we are expecting 6 or even more our GDP rates, and ratio and infrastructure. Actually, not only the Nepal, lots of multilateral agencies, including World Bank and Asian Development Bank and other agencies, and also the country like India, China, US, and some other countries, they have started massive investment in our infrastructure development. So now we are getting many more hands, many more wings, and lots of opportunities, possibilities, to get the strengthen our connectivity throughout the country. So whether you are investing or whether you are choosing east side or west side or north side or south side of Nepal, you'll have plenty of connectivity options and opportunity in Nepal. And nowadays, government of Nepal has special types of authority that if you have more than 100 million budget, or if you really want to work on the 100 million or more size of the project, there is investment board who is supporting all types of facilitation. If it is more than 20 million and below than 100 million, then we have investment board, promotion board, who have been handling or supporting, coordinating, facilitating to your project management, investment management. And then we have Department of Industries, similar as India. But we handle less than 20 million budget, less than 20 million budget, it is getting approved by the Department of Industry in Nepal. So our law is very much changed. And just recently, since last two years, we have worked in our foreign direct investment law, industry law, labor law, and infrastructure laws. So it's totally, we are offering very much a kind of environment that will help you in comparison to any country. So if you are having any types of project, we'll be working together, government will be providing road, electricity, and other types of infrastructure nearby your project. And government will also work, facilitate some of the funding issues. And if you want to really engage with some agencies like IFC, World Bank, and ADB, and some other agencies. And then we have lots of companies like commerce or companies which is looking after your operation and management. If you want to have your marketing networking system, chain of value chain market, and some other things. And then financial and taxation is one of the most charming and attractive point for the, especially for the Indian investors, that no one country in the world that's offering, especially for the Indian investors. Project banks, especially today I would like to offer you 10 sectors. It's one of the most lucrative sector in Nepal, where Indian investors are getting more than 2 to 3,000% of benefit for their investment, like company like Dabur, company like Patanjali, some other company, Unilever. They are getting more than 2 to 3,000% of their income or in benefits from their investment. So let me show a small video where you will see there is a kind of project bank where you can offer. Especially for all of you, if you have even a small budget or medium type of budget or big budget, we could really work on that. And Nepal, it's guarantee. Government of Nepal would offer a kind of a special guarantee that all the foreign investor entitles to 100% repatriation to the following amount outside Nepal. So sale of the share of foreign investment as whole or any payment thereof, profit or dividend or lieu of investment, payment of the principal and interest, whatever you have, and if you want to repatriate back to India, that's possible in Nepal, only in Nepal. So lots of things like foreign investors shall be entitled to repatriate outside Nepal amount received under an agreement. So just, it's a very simple process. It's a very special types of customized process for the Indian investors. And there is 100% grant assistance on building public infrastructure to the business location. Like as I told you, dedicated road, dedicated transmission line, it can be done by the government agency. So now we have also lots of tax exemptions, lots of tax facilities, and lots of other offers. It also includes financial types of incentives like VAT refund and some other types of refund in some cases. So we can work on it. So if you have, like, for instance, a maximum 10 year and up to 90% rebate on income tax, and now we have lots of offer also from the federal government, offer from the state government, and offers from the local government, like lots of export duties and other things we can offer. And then government has committed to provide security to all industrial. That's why we have now special types of industrial security things. So these are some kinds of incentives that we facilitate from our government side. And of course, Nepal is a very strategic location.